So now we come to what was at the time a bonus countdown, since originally the top 11 KTChamberlain anime theme songs was supposed to be uploaded at that time, but due to problems with YouTube, I had to think of a bonus one to make up for lost time. And I saw Jack's countdown on worst anime characters to be stuck on an island with. And just like the WTF moments list, I decided to have a crack at it. You know, pick the ones that I would never want to be stuck with on an island. So let's get started. At number 11, I had silent and emotionless characters. Now, I know, as I said, I'm cheating on two counts. What do I mean by that? It's that on one count, I try to stick to one character per franchise, and the other count was that I made the same selection Jack did in his top 10 list on worst characters to be stuck on an island with. But to be fair, I did not want to use the same silent and emotionless type of characters to make my point. At number 10 on his list, he had silent and emotionless characters like Yuki Nagato from Haruhi Suzumiya, quiet girl whose name I can't remember from canon. And the same thing goes with that one girl from Lucky Star, I can't remember her name. So I had silent type of characters like Sesshomaru and Haji. The pity is that I stupidly forgot to include two more silent and emotionless characters like Chad from Bleach and Sakaki from Azumanga Daioh. And again, I like those characters, but I don't like it when it's too quiet on an island and I'm the only one trying to strike up a conversation to make things a little more palatable. At number 10, I had Light Yagami from Death Note. Honest to God, I'd rather be stuck with Ryuk, because at least Ryuk and I would share some common ground that we both like red apples and would do the things to survive. Light would just sit on his ass and complain. Now, I gotta point out a minor screw-up that I made in this video. I said that why I placed him low on the list was that I could always take that Death Note of his and use it for kindling. I added, sure, he'll die after, like, what, 13 days of not killing someone with it? But hey, one less pain in the ass to deal with. But it was pointed out to me that the 13-day rule was fake. Well, as I said, I did catch some episodes of Death Note, and I remember hearing something about the 13-day rule with Death Note. What was the purpose of having that if it was a lie? Was it the show's way of giving us the bird? If so, I wouldn't be surprised. At number 9, I had Yajirobe from Dragon Ball Z. This fat Raditz cosplayer is like the human version of Muta from The Cat Returns. Speaking of which, before Jack's account got taken down, he did pick Muta at number 9 on his particular list. This fat ass would most likely eat up all the food you've collected. He does have his moments, but bear in mind that his heroism is brief and not reliable. At number 8, I had Jushiru Ukitake from Bleach. Now, don't get me wrong, I do like Ukitake. It's just that the biggest drawback to him is that damn lung ailment that he was born with that crops up every once in a while. That was how it turned his hair white, for the record. Now, I know it's not his fault, and there's nothing he can do about it. It's just that if you're stranded with him, you'd have another problem on your slate, especially if you don't know medicine study, which I don't. It's never a good sign when someone like Ukitake is coughing up blood and you don't know the first thing about medicine, especially if the island you're stuck on is a desert island. In that case, he'd be JWF, jolly well fucked. Sure, you don't have to save him, but he's such a nice guy and you couldn't bear to leave him for dead. At number 7, I had Kagura Soma slash Toru Honda from Fruits Basket. It was a tough call with Miss Piggy on steroids and the stress case. A woman that's so sporadic and another that would work herself to death wouldn't exactly be helpful in the grand scheme of things, sadly. Kagura would kick my ass because I'm a lot like Kyo, and Toru would just overwork herself despite my advice and therefore would make matters worse, and that's all. At number 6, I had Ayu Sukimiya from Canon. In Jack's countdown, at number 6, he had Mikuru Asahina from Haruhi Suzumiya. And Ayu is a bloody coward and a crybaby on par with Mikuru. Speaking of which, she does look like Mikuru. Isn't that weird? At number 5, I had Shinji Ikari from Neon Genesis Evangelion. Little Miss Whiny Bitch is among the top 5 you never want to be stuck with. This is yet another character that George's patent should slap.
We would have a yellow bastard sitting here crying in front of these brave men who've been wounded in battle.
Trust me when I say you'd be better off without one of the worst anime characters ever created. If it wasn't for the whole Eva pilot thing, he'd be completely useless in the show. Like Victor Mature, Cecil B. DeMille would brand Shinji Ikari 100% yellow. At number 4, I had She-Ra from Oshitei Remade. To make this character more helpful, you'd have to take away all her weapons, as well as ammunition, otherwise she'll go batshit crazy over the tiniest thing like a ladybug and go commando. And if you're on an island, it'd be likely there'd be all sorts of bugs, and you'd have a 5% chance of surviving if she goes batshit crazy with a machine gun. And that's why she's at number 4, people. At number 3, I had Lin Yao from Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood. Someone said, better watch out, Lan Fine might get you. And to that, I said, she can go ahead and try, because if she was stuck on an island with him, she'd eventually get fed up with him, kill him, and make it look like an accident. Only reason why she never did that in Amestris is because she knows Old Man Fu would either kill her himself if she did that, or have the clan give her the death penalty for insubordination. But hey, I still stand by the fact that an overly egotistical, obnoxious, mooching son of a bitch is among the top 5 worst anime characters you'd ever want to be stuck with. I'd go Kratos on his ass and rip his head off in the same way, with my bare hands. At number 2, I had Dokoro from Bludgeoning Angel Dokoro-chan. I've said it before and I'll say it again and again as long as it takes. Who'd want to be stuck with this violent, crazy bitch? She'd freak out over the tiniest things and kill you and revive you. Lather, rinse, repeat. I rest my case. And at number 1, I had Diana Kuraha Shiratori from Eden of the East. This character was picked purely from a male standpoint. If you're a male, you'd never want to be stranded on an island with a notorious angel whose trademark is to capture men deemed unfit and cut off their penis and let them bleed to death. I don't think so. Now, some people have pointed out that she's an angel and could fly away, leave you stranded, blah blah blah. But if birds never fly far from shore, otherwise they die, does that not also apply to an angel? The part I'm confused about is that is she an actual angel, like, straight from heaven, or is she a genetically engineered, like the flock in Maximum Ride? But still, I can imagine being in the same room and survive unscathed, but an island would be a completely different story. You see, you never quite know what she's going to do. She does what she damn well feels like. I'd rather not take my chances with a woman that notorious. If I had to, I'd take my chances out there on the ocean than to risk dying in one of the worst ways possible, especially if my manhood would be at stake. So that was revisiting the top 11 worst anime characters to be stuck on an island with. Thanks for watching, and special thanks to KHF, for if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have made this video, and therefore, this video wouldn't have made it either.